Was U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi fined $40,000 for destruction government property for shredding her copy of President Donald Trump's State of the Union address? No, that's not true. This is a work of satire that has been ripped off by real fake news sites and presented as truth. First, copies of the speech do not belong to the National Archives, and second, the writer of the original post creates such hoaxes to fool conservatives into believing and sharing these made-up stories. The claim originated from an article published by Taters Gunna Tate on February 5, 2020, titled, Nancy Pelosi Fined $40,000 for Destruction of Government Property, which opened, quote, Nancy Pelosi went too far when she ripped up the president's speech. According to federal statute USC Title 26 SS 197, all speeches given before Congress are to be preserved by the Speaker of the House and delivered to the National Archives for safekeeping. Pelosi wasn't just disrespectful, she broke the law. While there is no jail term for the offense, the fine is clear, the speaker will pay a fine equal to one-tenth of a presidential salary. As of now, that fine is $40,000, even though Trump doesn't technically take a salary. The Department of Justice says they will enforce the rule. According to Chief Prosecutorial Director Art Tubbles, the fine is automatic even though it hasn't been enforced since Tip O'Neill spit on Reagan's 1982 SOTU speech and refused to hand it over. It was only $20,000 then, but he paid it. Nancy Pelosi will pay this fine or find herself in contempt of a Justice Department directive, which does carry a jail sentence. This wasn't a smart thing to do. Hopefully, the voters of America will take notice and vote against her in the next speaker's race. End quote. Users on social media only saw this title, description and thumbnail, quote. Nancy Pelosi fined $40,000 for destruction of government property. SOTU speeches belong in the National Archives. End quote. There are many hidden jokes and outright fabrications in this story, which was debunked here by Snopes. For example, there is no law for forbidding the destruction of personal copies of the State of the Union. The relevant law, which does not apply here, reads, quote, 18 U.S. Code Section 2071, concealment, removal, or mutilation generally, a whoever willfully and unlawfully conceals, removes, mutilates, obliterates, or destroys, or attempts to do so, or, with intent to do so, takes and carries away any record, proceeding, map, book, paper, document, or other thing, filed or deposited with any clerk or officer of any court of the United States, or in any public office, or with any judicial or public officer of the United States, shall be fined under this title or imprisoned not more than 3 years, or both. B. Whoever, having the custody of any such record, proceeding, map, book, document, paper, or other thing, willfully and unlawfully conceals, removes, mutilates, obliterates, falsifies, or destroys the same, shall be fined under this title or imprisoned not more than 3 years, or both, and shall forfeit his office and be disqualified from holding any office under the United States. End quote. Still, Congressman Matt Gaetz, a Florida Republican, did file an ethics complaint after Pelosi, as the SOTU speech finished, ripped her copy in half. In response, Florida's Miami-Dade Democratic Party filed a complaint against Gaetz for grave misconduct. For those still questioning if the Taters Gunna Tate story is fiction, there is no race for the Speaker of the U.S. House. Position Pelosi was put in by members of her party, the Democrats, which hold a majority in the U.S. House. Also, the position of Chief Prosecutorial Director does not exist, and the supposed director, Art Tubbles, is an anagram for Busta Troll, a nom de plume for Christopher Blair, who runs many satirical sites that include Tate's Gunna Tate. The site is part of the America's Last Line of Defense network of satire websites run by self-professed liberal troll Christopher Blair from Maine, along with a loose confederation of friends and allies. Blair has been in a feud with fact-checking website Snopes for some time now and has also criticized other fact-checkers in the past who labeled his work fake news instead of satire. In reaction to this, he has rebranded all his active websites and Facebook pages so they carry prominent disclaimers. Every site in the network has an about page that reads, in part, quote, about satire before you complain and decide satire is synonymous with comedy, satire sati. are noun the use of humor, irony, exaggeration, or ridicule to expose and criticize people's stupidity or vices, particularly in the context of contemporary politics and other topical issues. Everything on this website is fiction. It is not a lie and it is not fake news because it is not real.